We all know that in the past decade, women have come out of America's kitchens and into America's workplace, and that's good. Amy Huggins is on the set with us with a story of one such woman whose office is on some of the street corners of the sleaziest streets of South Florida. Amy?
I like to call this a look at the real Miami Vice, and this is unlike the TV show of the same name. We're not going to show you this woman's face because we agreed to protect her identity. But you don't have to see what she looks like to get a good idea of what's going on out there on the streets of Miami. And one other word of caution. Some of you might find the nature of this story objectionable, and you might want to ask your children to leave the room.
Here comes old Rose. She's looking mighty fine. Here comes hot Nancy. She's stepping right on time.
On any given night in Miami, dozens of women go to work walking the streets looking for business. Shirley Harvard is one of them, but she's got the law on her side. She's an undercover cop with the Miami Police Department's Vice and Narcotics Squad. And it's her job to bust the men who buy sex by posing as a hooker.
Uh-oh. Miami Vice.
Oh,
jeez. You ever been arrested? Okay, I'll tell you what, if you've never been arrested, you won't go to jail.
This guy was one of six Shirley and her backup officers busted one night recently on the Tamiami Trail. The law prevents Shirley from coming on to men by dressing or speaking seductively. She's not allowed to name a sexual act or quote a price. She can only hang out on the corner waiting for them to come to her.
How you doing?
Hi.
I'm just looking for $20.
Huh?
$20?
Shirley helps fellow officers write up the paperwork so she can hurry back to the street and make another bust.
I enjoy doing it when I got the people to stop out there and I get an opportunity to arrest them.
What's your name?
Shirley.
Shirley?
Yeah.
How much
you got?
Five.
Okay, park, and I got a room over here. I swear he asked me for $5. Cheapskate. Police, get out the car.
Is it degrading?
I wouldn't say degrading. Because of the reason for me being out there. For a hooker, I would say so.
What seems to be an unusual and even dangerous job to most of us is pretty routine for Shirley.
I don't go out there taking the things I have to do personal. When I'm at work, I do what's expected of me to do, and when I go home, I forget about it.
Home is in Overtown with her 11-year-old daughter.
My daughter, she always asks questions about it. I don't get into detail with her. I just tell her that it's a part of my job and I'm working.
Working?
Yep. What you doing?
Looking for work?
Shirley didn't set out to be a vice cop. She says she was recruited for it about 2.5 years ago. Her boss, Sergeant Mike Ahern, says she's worked out real well.
When you get a good one, you want to hold on to her.
Shirley a good one?
She's very good.
Could you use more women like Shirley in the police force?
Oh, about 45 or 50, maybe.
Like in the car, maybe?
What you want?
How much? 20?
Okay.
All right.
Why don't you pull in right in the driveway there? Right there in the driveway, and I'll walk back here.
One reason Shirley likes her job is that it gives her more contact with the public.
You get businessmen. Sometimes you get local people that's working. They on the job working and stop. You get a few sleazeballs, too, but it's all different types of people.
Including those who know what they want but need a little help expressing themselves in English.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
I want you.
How much you got?
On the thing.
Me either.
What to do?
No, I don't speak Spanish.
How much?
How much for what? These guys, the majority of them, they are funny. They keep me laughing more than anything. Sometimes I laugh before I even start the paperwork. I have to wait to stop laughing.
Shirley wasn't laughing this night. She stood out in the rain for 4 hours and couldn't get anybody. Then something extraordinary happened that took everyone by surprise. A customer finally took the bait. But this was no ordinary customer who Shirley tried to bust in a motel room.
Guess what?
We'll
put these
up. Guess what? Me too. I knew it was how I get you.
That's right. It looks like two cops trying to out-undercover one another.
This customer, Dade County Police Officer Ron McPhee, told Shirley and her backups he was working the vice detail for the county. McPhee's superiors say yes, he was on duty, but aren't sure he was supposed to be on the hooker patrol. McPhee's been assigned to desk duty while his case is investigated. The incident raised Shirley's eyebrows, but it's back to the street for her, where maybe next time she'll collar a drug dealer or fugitive. Like she says, she loves her job because of all the interesting people she gets to meet.
That Shirley is a very interesting woman, but what happened to that officer under investigation?
The preliminary report on him is complete, and the final recommendations on what, if any, action should be taken against him is expected in a few days.
I have to ask this. Is this operation doing us any good? I mean, we're spending an awful lot of money and manpower hours. Shouldn't they be out busting drug dealers or muggers or murderers or something?
Part of this unit's work does include busting drug dealers, and in fact, they don't go out on this particular patrol unless they don't have anything better to do. They realize it is not at the very top of the priority list.
Private question to you, Amy. What's it like hidden off behind the door there and watching this going on?
It was real exciting for about 5 minutes, and after that, it got real boring. It's not at all like what we see on TV.
But it's still vital.
Yes, it is.
Thank you very much, Amy.